This is JB from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time I will be trying out Nathaniel Cho, the new starter deck Guardian that just was released a short time ago. I won't be playing with the starter deck, but I have made a true solo deck for Nathaniel Cho and trying it out because I think Nathaniel Cho straight out of the starter deck is maybe the worst of the bunch as a true solo investigator. So I made a lot of changes to the deck and I am trying Nathaniel out in Return to the Curtain Call, which is one of my favorite scenarios to test out decks before a campaign run, for example. I won't be playing a campaign with Nathaniel, but just trying him out as a solo investigator. So let's look at the deck first. As you can see, there are no boxing gloves in the deck. This is because there are only four copies of a spirit event, so the boxing gloves don't do that much in this build. Instead, because Nathaniel has a high fight value, I added two copies of 32 Colts in the deck. There are also flashlights for investigating as hand slot assets, and also two enchanted blades to have something against the poltergeists that are in this scenario. Because Nathaniel has a hard time with horror damage, there are something but fighting force. I was debating on having other horror soaks in the deck, but ended up using only the something worth fighting force. Also, Randall Cho has a good horror soak, and the other ally in the deck is the new Grete Wagner, which I can't pronounce probably correctly. And on the event side, I added all of the Guardian events that help getting clues, like evidence, interrogate, which is a bit of a situational event, but could be really good because there are a lot of humanoid enemies in this scenario and in the Path to Carcosa campaign altogether. There are also Scene of the Crimes, and to help get the right treachery cards, I have also added On the Hunts into the deck, so instead of getting a bad treachery, we can search for an enemy when we are at a location with clues, so that we can use the Scene of the Crime. Other than that, I added quite a lot of skill cards into the deck, two perceptions to help with the investigating, Steadfast, which will help with will power checks and fighting checks. Take the Initiative is really good for the treacheries, and Vicious Blows, of course, to help out defeating enemies. The random basic weakness is Haunted, so it's not that bad, and of course there's the signature enemy weakness, Tommy Malloy, which will be quite annoying for Nathaniel to deal with. But that's enough of the deck. Let's see the scenario before we start. So we are starting in the theater. We are playing the Return to version, so the Royal Emissary will get buffed up every time we defeat it. The defeating of the Royal Emissary won't be that hard for Nathaniel, but I think a lot of the rest of the scenario will be quite difficult. So let's see how this goes. So let's get started. I have reshuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. Five cards. We get something worth fighting for, perception, interrogate, clean them out, and take the initiative. Okay, I think we'll keep the perception. We'll also keep take the initiative. And I think I'll mulligan the rest. So we mulligan the enemy. So we got 32 Colt, Enchanted Blade, and 1-2 Punch. So at least we have weapons to fight at the start. I think I will play the Enchanted Blade down first. That is because if we hit the early Poltergeist, we won't be stuck with it for too long. Let's just use the Enchanted Blade because it's a relic, so we can defeat the Poltergeist with it. We are starting in the theater. It's a two-shroud location with zero clues, so we need to start moving around and looking for clues right from the start. And I just noticed I forgot to add the action counters. Okay, so let's start by playing down the Enchanted Blade. It comes into play with three charges. Second action, I'll move to the backstage. Backstage is a three shroud location with one clue. Forced effect: when backstage is revealed, put two of the set aside backstage doorway locations to play at random. While you are at backstage, each hidden treasure in your hand counts as three cards instead of one for the purpose of counting your hand size. So we have the four backstage locations. So three of them are from the core campaign, and one of them is from the return to version of the Path to Carcosa. So shuffle them up and put two of them into play. Just put them like so. And we need three clues to advance the Act 1. So let's see if we can grab this one clue from here. Last action. We could play the perception, so we will be investigating 4 versus 3. I think that's not good enough, so I think I'll just grab a resource for our last action, and that's our turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we gain vicious blow, and we gain one resource. So that's the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. The threshold is 6. The first encounter card is a swarm of rats, so that won't be a problem for Nathaniel. He can basically just punch through the rats. Unfortunately, we don't have a card to get the clues from this location. So, let's see. We'll just punch the rats. So, I am fighting 5 versus 1. And it's an Elder Sign. So, Nathaniel's Elder Sign effect is plus 1 if this skill test is successful during an attack. Return an event from your discard pile into your hand. So, it wasn't an attack. So, we just defeat the rats. Second action. I think I'll leave the clue here for now and let go investigate the other backstage. And it's the dressing room. It's a 4-shroud location with 0 clues, triple action heal, 3 horror. Well, nothing here for us to do, so we'll just head back to the backstage, and that is our whole turn. We gain one resource, and we draw a card, and we get on the hunt. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom onto the agenda. encounter card for this journey is... It's the Spars of Carcosa. Well, this is a bad one. Attach to your location, then place 2 Doom on that location. So... action investigate. If you succeed, instead of discovering clues here, remove 1 Doom from attached location. I think we just have to ignore this. We don't have the investigative power to do anything about that. So, as a first action, we'll move to the other backstage. So, it's the trap room. It's a 3 shroud location with 1 clue. And after you reveal the trap room, search the encounter deck and discard file for 1 copy of Swarm Threats and put it in play. So we get another Swarm of Threats. I really would like to find one fanatic that just grabs the clues and we can just punch them and get the clues from them. But it is what it is. So the rats engage us. And second action, we'll just punch the rats. And it's a minus one, so the rats are dead. And last action, I think I'll have to try investigating here. So I'll use the perception. And let's see how it goes. So 4 versus 3. It's a minus 1. So we luck out and get the clue. And we also draw a card with the perception. So we get another perception. Nice. And that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get evidence. Nice. And we gain 1 resource. So, I think next turn we could on the hunt and try to get a fanatic here and move in, defeat it and get the... Well, we get the clue either way, but... Yeah, let's see. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 Doom of 6. And the encounter card. Well, let's think about this now. We could play on the hunt. And then try to get a fanatic to the backstage. I think I'll do that. So I'll play the, on the hunt. So first play when you would draw an encounter card during the middle space. Instead, search the top 9, top 9 cards. Of the encounter deck for an enemy, spawn it, engage with you instead of its normal spawn location. Yeah, let's not do that because that fanatic would spawn on our location and won't get any clues, so it doesn't help us at all. So let's just draw the encounter card and see what we get. So we get the Melancholy. Put Melancholy into play in your threat area. Increase the resource cost of each card in your hand by 1. At the end of your turn, test Willpower 3. If you succeed, discard Melancholy. Okay. First action, we'll move to the backstage. Second action, it will try to investigate using the perception. So, I am investigating 4 versus 3. It's unfortunately a minus 2, so we fail. And... last action, I think I will... play down the Colt. So that we have a backup weapon. Because next turn the Royal Emissary will spawn, so we don't want to use the Enchanted Blade and waste charges for that. So the Colt comes into play with 6 ammo. And that is our turn. No enemies. Let's try to get rid of the melancholy. So we are testing 3 versus 3. I'm just checking if I have anything to commit. No. So 3 versus 3. It's a minus 2. We don't get rid of it. Oh yeah, and the cold cost 1 more. So upkeep. We get a flashlight and we gain 1 resource. So, and now I would really have wanted to play the flashlight rather than the Colt, but it is what it is. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 6 Doom of 6, so we have to advance the agenda. So we set the set aside cards and victor display for the Royal Emissary enemy and spawn it in the theater. So Royal Emissary is a 4 fight, 4 health to evade monster elite, and it is prey lowest willpower, massive hunter retaliate, forced at the end of the enemy phase, each investigator at Royal Emissary's location or a connected location takes 1 horror. So I think we are heading into the theater and gonna want to punch that guy away. And the encounter card for this turn is the King's Edict. Well, there are no cultists here, so this gains surge, so we get the visions in your mind failure. Peril hidden revelation, secretly add this card into your hand, forced when your turn ends. If you did not perform at least 1 resource action during your turn, discard this card and take 1 direct damage and horror. So I think we'll be taking those. Okay, so first action we'll move into the theater. So because Emissary is massive, it is engaged with us. So I will attack the Emissary, so that costs 3 because of the melancholy. And when you deal damage to an enemy by an event or a fight ability on an event, deal 1 additional damage. So for the first hit, we will deal 2 damage. So we are fighting 6 versus 4. And it's a minus 1, so we deal 2 damage. Then we get to fight again. Now we are fighting 7 versus 4, and the second attack deals plus 1 damage. And of course it's another fail, so the Emissary retaliates, we take 2 damage. Okay, well, let's see then what we can do. So I think we're just using the Colt. So we are fighting 5 versus 4. Actually, I'll save the Colt and I'll use the Vicious Blow. So we're fighting 6 versus 4. It's a skull, it's a minus 1. So we defeat the Royal Emissary. So the Emissary goes into the victory display. And after Royal Emissary is added to the victory display, remove all doom from... Yeah, this would have been removed. Remove all doom from play and reset the agenda deck to agenda 1A. So we reset this to one A, and we add three Doom on it. And also, we have the return to version of this scenario, we add one counter here, so next time the emissary comes into play, it has one more health. So that was our turn. We test the melancholy. And it's an elder sign. So we get rid of the melancholy. And no enemies. We go to upkeep. We are ready. We draw a scene of the crime and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom onto the agenda. The encounter card for this turn is King's Edict. It searches, so we get another card. We get Painful Reflection. Put Painful Reflection into play in your threat area. When you play an event, reveal a random token from the Chaos Pack. If it's a Skull, Cultist, Tablet, Elder Thing, or Autofill token, cancel that event, take one horror, and discard Painful Reflection. Okay, first action, we'll move to the lobby. It's a four-strat location with one clue. Then we put two random lobby locations in the play. So again, there are three from the basic Pat Carcosa campaign and one from the return to version. So we put two in the play. And I think we'll keep moving. I'll head to the balcony actually. Yeah, so the balcony is a two-shot location with one clue. After you perform a move action during which you move from the balcony to the theater, take two damage. And last action, I think I'll just investigate here. I won't commit anything to the test. So I'm investigating 2 versus 2. I think I'll commit the flashlight, I'm not playing it. So 3 versus 2. And it's an auto fail, of course it is. So we fail, and that is our turn. No enemies. Oh yeah, and this would have triggered a while ago. So let's just add these. So we draw a card, we get something worth fighting for, and we gain one resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 Doom of 6. Encounter card for this turn is a Fanatic. Finally, something we wanted to see. So the Fanatic grabs the clue. It spawns revealed location with most clues. So actually, let's make things a bit easier for us. So I'll spawn it in the lobby. Just so that it grabs a clue from a high shroud location. Then, first action, I will use Scene of the Crime as first action. We'll grab this clue here. Second action, we'll move down to the lobby. And this Fanatic engages us. Last action, we will shoot the Fanatic. I am shooting. We have to check if that event didn't go off. It's a zero, so we're fine. And now we're fighting 5 versus 3 against the Fanatic. I think we're fine with those odds. Let's do this way. So I'm using the enchanted blade. So now I have a plus 2, so I have a You get plus one for this attack as an additional cost in each end that you may spend one charge to power play. If you do, you get plus one and three one. Yeah. So we have a plus two and 7 versus 3. It's a minus four, so good thing we use that. So we get the clue. And this fanatic is defeated. And that is our turn. So no enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw interrogates and we gain one resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are again at 6 Doom of 6. So the emissary spawns into the theater. And Count Cordis. Voice of Trunembra. Peril, test willpower 3. For each point you fail while, you must choose a different option. Lose 2 resources, take 1 horror, get minus 2 to the next skill test you perform this round. I think I'll commit to take the initiative this test. So I'm testing 6 versus 3. Try this again. So it's a 0. We pass and we don't have to do anything. Then we will use the clues to advance. So choose one of the set aside location at random, put that location in the play and spawn the set aside. The man in the pallid mass, enemy at that location instead of his normal spawn location, advance to one of the 3 copies of Act 2 at random, remove the other 2 copies of Act 2 from the game without looking at them. So in the return to version there are 3 more of those, so there are 6, and I already picked one at random during setup, so we'll just randomize these cards and I will pick the one that is at the bottom. I'm not trying to look which one we get. Okay, so we get a backstage doorway, which is a shame because we really would have wanted to have it near here. So the man in the pallid mask spawns here. And we need to move there. Okay, and that's the mythos phase. And yeah, so we spawned the advanced act in the start of the investigation phase. So first action, we'll move to the theater. Oh yeah, now the emissary has 5 health. So, well, we can tank one turn from that emissary, so we'll just shoot. So, we are shooting 5 versus 4. It's a plus one. We'll deal 2 damage. And we'll shoot again. A 5 versus 4. It's a minus one. So we deal another 2 damage. And that is the investigation phase. Enemy phase. Emissary hits us for 2. And we'll take 1 horror from it screaming. Upkeep, we draw 1 card. We get Gret Wagner and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom onto the agenda. Encounter card is Spirit's Torment attached to your location. After you leave the attached location, you must either take one horror or lose one action. Place one of your clues at the attached location, discard Spirit's Torment. Well, this is annoying. We can't do much about that. First action, I'll use the Enchanted Blade to hit the emissary. I think I won't need the charge. So I'm hitting 6 versus 4. Yeah, let's just hit 6 versus 4. It's a plus 1, so the emissary is defeated. We add a resource here, so next time the emissary has 6 health. Second action. I think we'll just use double action to move. And that is our turn. We have no enemies, so we go to upkeep, we draw a card, and gain one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, and again, we would have resetted this last turn. So we add a threat to the agenda. The encounter card for this turn is actually... before we do that, I will play on the hunt. Do we need the clues? We don't. Let's forget about that. So we just take the counterpart. We get the voice of Trudembra again. This time I'll just test it 3 versus 3. It's a skull, it's a minus 1. So we fail by 1. I'll take one horror. No, that would make the skulls even worse. I think I have to lose the resources. And that's the mythos phase done. Investigation phase. We'll move into the backstage doorway. It's the rehearsal room, one shroud location with one clue. Forced after you succeed by 2 or more while investigating the rehearsal room, take one horror. So, come just investigate in 2 versus 1. I try to get the victory points. So it's a 0. So we succeed, but we don't succeed by 2 or more. And then I think I will take a resource. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep. We draw a card, we get Randall Joe, and we gain one resource. Okay, so that is... Actually, Randall Joe is really good, because now we can heal 3 damage, because we don't need to search for weapons. So I think we're playing Randall next turn. So yeah, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are again at 5 Doom of 6 encounter card. It's Voice of Trunembra. I think I'm committing to something worth fighting for this test. So 4 versus 3. It's a minus 2, so we fail by 1. I think I'm losing the resources. We can wait with the ally. This turn I will engage the man in the pallid mask. And then I will hit. Actually, the shroud here is really low. So let's try it another way. So let's not engage. We'll do the investigate. So we are committing interrogate and evidence and Greta to the test. So we are investigating 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 versus 3. And it's a minus 4, so we fail. Of course we fail. Well, that's not surprising with my luck. We'll try to investigate again. We'll commit Randall Joe to the test, and we'll commit on the hunt. So, 5 versus 3. And it's a skull, so it's a minus 1. So we succeed. We defeat the man in the pallid mask for a moment. We'll advance the stranger. So, the shores of Holly. Instead of discarding the man in the pallid mask, move him to the lobby. Add 2 Elderting tokens to the chaos bags. Place 1 horror on each private location. Until the end of the scenario, horror on locations represent floating water, and each location with horror gains forced when you would leave this location. Test agility 2. If you fail, take 1 damage and cancel the effect of the move limit once per round. So this is private, this is private, this is private. This is private, and this is private. Keep this card as a reminder. Curtain call. So, while the man in the pallid mask is not in play, the lobby gains action resign. Forced at the end of the round, place 1 horror on each location with no horror that is connected to that location with horror. If each undefeated investigator has resigned, advance. Okay, and last action. We'll try to move to the backstage. And indeed, we are trying, so we are testing agility 2 versus 2. We have nothing to boost that with. And it's a minus 4. And we'll take 1 damage and cancel the move. So now I just remembered that we should have not done that this turn, because we can only fail it once. Next turn we can fail it again. Well, it is what it is. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get a flashlight, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, and before we go to the next turn, we'll plot these locations, and now we can go to the next turn. So, we are again at 6. Doom of 6. So, the emissary spawns again here. Now it has 6 health. So yeah, encounter card for this turn is it's the Spirit's Torment. Okay. I think we're really stuck here now. I think this turn we're just trying to get some cards to help us. So first action, I'll draw a card. So that's useful. Second action, we'll draw a card. Evidence, not that useful. Last action, we draw a card. Take the initiative. That's really useful next turn when we try to leave this location. Enemy phase, emissary moves here. We'll get one horror from the screeching. And that is our turn, so upkeep, we ready up, we draw a card, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom onto the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is Spires of Carcosa. Well, we're not doing that. First action, we'll move. We'll just take the horror. So first action, we'll take the initiative and move out. So 5 versus 2. It's a 0. We move out. Second action. We'll hit the emissary. I'm using the enchanted blade and on the hunt. So we are hitting 8 versus 4. Oh yeah, let's... before we... yeah, before we commit anything to the test, we'll check if we actually have to ignore the hunter punch. It's a minus 4, so we can play it. So now we commit these cards to the test, and... yeah, so 8 versus 4, it's a minus 4. So we take one horror. Well, that sucks, we're almost dead. But we hit, and because we used it, 1-2 punch and Nathaniel Cho, so we deal 1 extra damage. We get to hit again. We are hitting 7 versus 4. And it's a plus 1. We deal another 2 damage. Last action, we'll use the enchanted blade. So, we are hitting 7 versus 4. And it's a minus 3, but we still managed to hit. Just barely, so the emissary is defeated again. We had 1, so I think we're at the limit of how many times we can realistically defeat the emissary. So that was our turn. And we go back to this and remove all doom from play, so this goes away. And we add 3 doom here. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep. We gain a resource and draw a card, we get steadfast. Well, not that helpful, but it is what it is. And that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. Okay, we add a do. Encounter card is visions in your mind. So this... yeah, we had horror tokens on these locations. So basically we need to do at least one draw action or we die, because we are running out of sanity. Okay, well, first action. We try to move. We are testing 2 versus 2. We fail. And we're dead. because there is horror here. We drew the elder thing, so we take one horror. And that defeats us. So, unfortunately, we weren't able to get out. We still got 1, 2, 3, 4 experience. And we got the resolution. Let's see. So, in your camper log, we would record that the stranger is onto you at the man in the palina's weakness to the lead investigator's deck. Does not count towards deck size for the remainder of the campaign. Anytime the dear main man in the palina's leaves the campaign for any reason, choose a new investigator, etc. In your camper log, under chasing the stranger, place one tally mark for each time the man in the palina's was defeated during the scenario, but should not be one. For the remainder of the campaign, keep a running tally of the number of times the man in the palina's is defeated during a game. Each tally mark will bring you one step closer to the truth. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. So, we got 4 experience, that's okay. Not really anything special, but yeah. At least we got through the investigative part of this scenario with Nathaniel. But this is a rough scenario. I can say that with a straight face. Usually some of the not that good solo investigators don't even get this far, and we were able to defeat the emissary 3 times, which is quite a good result in the return to version, because it's gaining health every time you defeat it. But I think Nathaniel can be made into a true solo investigator, but he won't play like he does with the boxing gloves and all the events that come in the starter deck, so you shouldn't try that route if you're trying to solo investigate. But paired up, if you're playing two-handed or with another person who's playing a seeker, for example, you can build Nathaniel quite easily straight out of the box as a fighting character that doesn't do any clue getting. I like Nathaniel's style, but maybe not for true solo. I may try him later in a playthrough with two-handed, but not probably in a true solo scenario, unless it's a standalone or something like that. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that playthrough. Thanks for watching, and until next time.